for one, am grateful, Mrs. Bush, that they are finally bringing civilization to this savage land.
I could not agree with you more, my dear. My daddy settled this land, and I know he'll be looking down on us, pleased at how we helped the natives.
Yes, they've lost their land, but they've gained access to heaven.
But Father, do you mean unless an innocent receives communion, they're destined to go to hell? That hardly seems fair.
What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought of it that way.
Yes, they lived like animals, but they're happier now.
Not only do people now have motor cars, Father, but I heard that pretty soon we will be able to fly.
No, only angels can fly, Jenny.
No, apparently people can fly. Didn't you hear? Out in Kansas, a man even got a car to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
Apparently, Mr. Johns wants to run for governor, which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently. The Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity we have, the chance to live among people who are decent and who do not kill each other, and who let you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me if you need help.
Indeed.
Well, here we are, Mrs. Bush. Armadillo.
John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to guide you.
They ain't my friends, but pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out front. Come on, Mr. Marston. No need for that. Well, here, let's mount up and hit the trail. Gio! Easy on the spurs now. We don't need to draw undue attention. So is Fort Mercer you want to visit?
That's right.
Ain't taking nobody up to the fort in a long time. Strange place for a decent fella to want to visit, if you don't mind me saying.
Who said I was a decent fella?
It's been abandoned for years now. Folks say it was built during the Mexican War. What kinds of soldiers around back then?
Why'd they leave?
Well, I ain't entirely sure. I heard they had to go up north to fight Indians, or maybe they got tired of being soldiers and went looking for gold. You know how things is. So what are you doing up at the fort?
I'm looking for an old friend.
Well, like I says, you ain't gonna find many folk around those parts these days. Those you do find are about as sociable as an ulcerated back tooth. I mean, I ain't one to judge a man by the company he keeps, but...
Well, he ain't been friends for a long time.
Are you planning on spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you can do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Thieves Landing. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hold up with.
I'm a married man, I'm afraid.
Ain't we all? So it was the marshal who hired me, Lee Johnson. Do you know him?
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bugs asking for a guide. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah. You ain't very talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. It's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me, there's things you're better off not knowing.
Damn coyotes! What a waste of good meat! Not far now, Mr. Marston. The fort's just over this hill.
Listen, mister. This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Come for you! Bill Williamson! Come out here right now!
Go away now, John. Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill.
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill. I implore you, think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge! No more Dutch! And no more you. Implores. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well?
Oh. Poor guy.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die, Mr.
Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
Trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. Seen my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later? Help me patrol the perimeter. You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind.
Hello. How are you?
Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
Well, no time to wait. The horses are saddled up here.
There's the foreman's office. It's also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarlane.
Hop on up. He won't bite. Yeah! Come on, time for you to see what a real ranch looks like. Is the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
You've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better. Head out on patrol.
You'll get no complaints from me, Miss McFarlane.
Well, are we going inside? This is a patrol. You might need those bullets.
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house, and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarlane.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time.
Ready, Mr. Marston? Let's mount up and patrol the ranch. Keep your eyes peeled for anything suspicious. Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team. Again. Get down and give me a hand, will you? Much obliged for the help. Them rabbits can be wily little critters. Mount back up. We should check out the We've still got plenty of ground to cover. If it's not the rustlers stealing our cattle, it's the rabbits stealing our crops.
It ain't never easy living off the land like this. Maybe you should move to a big city, become a lady of leisure.
Was that a coyote? those pests before they scare the livestock.
I'm in a bad place.
You can actually handle a rifle.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
Here we are. Mr. Marston, makes me kind of happy I saved your life. Get some sleep and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarland.
Please be aware of a social disease carried by a certain young lady.
Follow Charlie. He's a good one to sniff out trouble. Stay close to Charlie.
Where is he, boy? If I see you here again, you're dead! Forgive me, friend.
How are you doing?
Thank you kindly.
Come on. There you are. Let's make this quick.
Hey, this way, friend.
Come on. This is dirty. Lie still. What were you eating? Let's go! Oh. Slow down! Might as well. I'll be having that. Yeah!
Hola.
Oh, Mr. Marston. How are you doing today?
I'm well, Miss McFarlane. Thank you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Thank you. So, how are your ribs?
Fine. A little sore, but apart from a couple extra scars, it'll be as nothing happened.
Good. Come in. You know, you never did tell me how you met that Bill Williamson or what you wanted from him.
No, miss, I did not.
Well, why not, if you don't mind me asking?
I certainly don't mind you asking if you don't mind me not telling. See, it's a complicated and somewhat pathetic tale, and by telling you, not only would I be putting your life in danger, but also threatening the lives of some people that I hold very dear.
Well, I apologize if I seem to be prying.
And I apologize for my reticence. Hope you believe me when I say that it's simply out of respect for you.
Of course, Mr. Marston. I understand that a city dweller such as yourself likes to have some exotic secrets so us country folk are impressed.
I'm no city man, miss.
Yeah, but I saw you get on the train at Blackwater. You with those gentlemen in bowler hats?
I'm still no city man.
But I'll bet you can't ride, Mr. Marston.
I hate to take money from a lady, miss.
Oh, you won't be. I'll race you right now.
If it makes you happy.
We'll see.
All right, I'll show you how. apart.
Come on.
Come on, boy. On the count of three. Three, two, one, go! I trust you're not gonna be a gentleman about this.
You don't know me at all, Miss McFarland. Sure.
You know, you should go pay the marshal a visit in Armadillo sometime. I'm sure he could help you deal with that nice Mr. Williamson.
Yeah, I might just do that, Miss McFarland.
You do whatever you think best, Mr. Marston. Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good, Miss McFarland. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. Take the reins, Mr. Marston. You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's a relief. Perhaps there's hope for you yet.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, there's always hope, Mr. Marston. You can't be a rancher in this kind of country if you don't believe that.
An admirable attitude, miss.
I suppose so. I can't think of any other way to stay sane, to be frank. What about you? Have you ever given up hope altogether?
Hope hasn't really entered into it. It's not really something I think about.
A peculiar outlook. I can't really say I understand you.
I can't always say I do either.
Oh, don't be so deliberately enigmatic.
I'm not, miss.
Yes, you are. You are being deliberately obscure as a substitute for having a personality.
I just know there are two theories to arguing with women, and neither one works.
I'm not even going to dignify that gibberish with a response. Perhaps, but not rotten. I just worry about you gallivanting around these parts like you're some kind of deranged bounty hunter. Like Paul always says, don't go waking snakes.
I appreciate your concern for us lesser mortals, Miss McFarlane. I really do. And if there was any other way out, I'd take it. I can assure you of that.
Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. The first one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done.
Not feeling ill, I hope.
Dear sir, hello.
You have any night fevers, come back and see me.
Much obliged. Hello to you, ma'am.
Hello there.
Good it is to see you.
Hello.
Hello there.
Well, thanks for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once. And a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
Friend.
Okay, I'm always in the market for interesting goods. A fine choice.
Let's go!
Ain't no man in my eyes.
Everything all right, madam?
It's Miss... Oh! Oh, let me look at you. My gentleman caller. You remind me of my Peter. Have you seen him?
I don't think so.
Where is that man? We'll be late for the ceremony. He must still be at the saloon in Armadillo, talking to the musicians. He's such a fine man. Must be making things right for me, as usual.
Well, I gotta get going, ma'am. I'm sure your Peter will be just fine.
Wait, I beg you. Would you possibly go fetch him for me? This was meant to be my perfect day. Please, sir. Something must have happened. I can't bear it.
So you want me to go find your Peter so you can have a perfect day?
Yes, please, sir.
I'll see what I can do.
Oh.
Just so you know, I don't take requests, mister.
I'm looking for a man. Name's Peter. Fellow's meant to get married today. Seen him around?
Who?
Peter, what she said.
You ain't after no Pete Turner, are you?
For all I know, where can I find him?
Well, my memory escapes me when not properly stimulated.
And let's see if we can refresh it.
$5 will do. Or you could run a little errand for me.
What do you need done?
It's my wife. She packed her things this morning and left me. The dumb wench is still at the freight station waiting for the stagecoach. If you could convince her to take me back. Her name's Rose.
I guess I'll go have a talk with her.
Now, you'll need more than talk for that bitch.
Here, this might loosen your tongue.
Truth is, Pete Turner ain't been in Armadillo for near on 20 years now. Kind of a queer fella and all. Wasn't here every night, sure as the moon in the sky.
What happened to him?
Well, what happens to all of us? I reckon you'll find him at Odd Fellow's Rest. Yep. That's where he'd be, I'd guess.
me, friend. You or me. Go. Hey. Whoa, whoa. This'll fetch a good price. Howdy, miss. What are you doing out here?
I'm thinking.
Have I seen you before?
Yes, I think so. On the train from Blackwater, perhaps.
Yeah. Yeah, you were talking with the preacher.
Yes, sir, I was.
I don't know if it's so safe out here, miss.
Oh, Jenny. You can call me Jenny. All right. I'm safe because I have faith. So, faith can move mountains. That's the whole point.
You're trying to move a mountain?
Oh, no. I can't do anything. But with faith, I can achieve great things. I know that. I know it.
You want me to take you back into town, ma'am? You seem kind of unwell.
Oh, I get such clarity out here. I see things purely. The world is so beautiful.
And full of things that'll kill you, including illness.
Nothing's gonna kill me, sir.
Well, take care then. Miss Jenny. Miss Jenny. Don't look like the Almighty's much inclined to help you out here. I was kind of worried about you, so I brought you some medicine.
Oh, heavens. Oh, praise you, Lord. I knew you'd save me.
Excuse me?
You see, it was only through His will that you were ordered to save me. Tell me, were there angels in your vision?
Jenny, can I take you back into town?
Praise you, Savior. I knew you'd save me.
Will you come with me?
Oh, I'm fine here, mister. I'm in heaven.